Okay, let's connect and talk about being an influencer.
TikTok, apparently quite a good gig if you're smart.
Yes, 2021's top earners are teenagers, and they're dancing their way to the bank. According to Forbes, dancer Charlie D'Amelio, her musician sister Dixie D'Amelio, and actress and influencer Addison Rae are the top TikTok earners. But don't forget internet celebrities Bella Poarch, Josh Richards, Chris Collins, and Avani Gregg. Dan, I know you know all these TikTokers.
I follow them all.
So they all made over $55.5 million collectively. That's triple what the top creators earned last year. Now, they don't make money on TikTok directly, but they use their TikTok fame to pivot to TV and film, recording deals, makeup lines, sponsorships from companies like Hollister, Amazon, and Google. Like Amazon or Addison Rae, she got some Netflix deal and was on one of those movies.
A couple of them, you know, and it's kind of funny to see them come in for interviews and stuff like that. And you think, who is this person?
Yeah, exactly.
What do they do? They're just on TikTok. That's it.
And they just do dances. You know, I was thinking about myself when I was a teenager and just like the weird things I would do, not like cool dances like that. You get dressed up in weird clothes.
Well, now put it on TikTok and see what happens.
What kind of deal you get, Danny.
Carrie, maybe we could become TikTok stars still. There's a chance.
You want to pair up with me? Wow.
You know, what we really need to do is get Dan dancing, and I think we could roll on into fame.
Okay.
I would have been really good at that, but, you know, our contracts don't allow us to make money off of other things like this, you know, and so otherwise, I would have been huge.
Yeah, he would have been. I get it.
Nobody would have wanted to watch it.
Let's talk about what else is trending this morning. Okay, if you've been on Twitter, you've most likely seen these green and yellow tiles all over your feed. I'm showing it to you right now. It's called Wordle. It's a game. It's kind of like a crossword without any clues. You have to guess the five-letter word. Incorrect letters turn gray. Correct letters turn yellow. A letter that's in the right spot turns green. And you only have 6 tries. Every day there's a new word. And then you can share your results on Twitter without sharing the actual word. So this is someone sharing his results. He says, I don't know what this means, but I was very impressed with myself. I guess what he did was good. Someone else posted this. My first ever go at Wordle. I'm going to retire now. That means he got it in 2 tries, I guess. Hmm. I think I'm still learning this myself. There's actually some funny memes coming out of this, though. This one says, there's no easy way to say this, so I'll just give it to you straight. Nobody cares about your Wordle score, because that's all over Twitter is people sharing their results. And then finally, Lego posted saying, can't stop imagining Wordle tiles as Lego bricks, which is so true.
Throwing in a little promo there.
Yeah, exactly. I haven't played it yet. I think I'd be really bad at it. But you don't get any clues.
Huh.
That's the bad part.
I still don't really understand the game. But
yeah.
All right.
Maybe it's for the younger
folks. Carrie, there's a new game for you that has little blocks in it and stuff.
Yes. So, okay, I'm going to give it a go.
Okay, we'll see how that goes.
I'm going to give Wordle a whirl.
I like that, Carrie.
Okay.
That should be their tagline. Okay, today's poll, we're asking you, it's the new year, 2022. Is it too late to wish someone a happy new year? We're a couple weeks into 2022. Most Utahns say no, though. So just say Happy New Year the rest of the year. We could all use it.
Yeah, just a little
like
pick-me-up.
A fresh start.
Yeah, just say something nice. And if it starts with Happy New Year, okay.
Happy New Year and go get your tires changed. Whatever it may be, just start it with Happy New Year.
Thanks, Danny.